हेलो एवरीवन, आप प्लीज कंफर्म वेदर आई ऑडिबल और नॉट। जो जो भी क्लास में है प्लीज कंफर्म। यस आई एम ऑडिबल। हेलो एवरीवन, गुड इवनिंग। जो भी क्लास में है गुड इवनिंग टू एवरीवन। एंड विल स्टार्ट द सेशन इन जस्ट 5 मिनट्स। ओके, लेट एवरीवन ज्वाइन इन। विल जस्ट स्टार्ट द सेशन इन 5 मिनट्स। ओके। हेलो कातुरी, हेलो कातुरी विनय, हेलो हेलो अश्विन, हेलो एवरीवन, ए वेरी गुड इवनिंग टू ईच एंड एवरीवन। आई विल इंट्रोड्यूस माय सेल्फ एंड देन आई विल स्टार्ट विद द सेशन। ओके, एंड द सेशन विल बी डिवाइडेड इनटू टू पार्ट्स। ओके, इन द फर्स्ट पार्ट व्हाट आई विल डू इज आई विल शेयर माय जर्नी, हाउ आई स्टार्टेड विद कोडशिफ्ट, हाउ आई प्रैक्टिस, व्हाट वाज माय स्ट्रेटजी इन प्रैक्टिसिंग एंड एवरीथिंग, व्हाट ऑल प्लेटफॉर्म्स डिड आई चूज एंड व्हाट रिसोर्सेज डिड आई फॉलो टू reach this level I am currently on, right? What interviews I have given, what interviews I have cracked. So I'll share my short journey about myself, starting from my first year in just 15 minutes. And then what I'll do is I'll share some tips, right? And some strategies which you can follow, some resources which you can follow to like become a level, to become a good level programmer. Okay. And after that, in the last 15 to 20 minutes, I'll give you a time. It will be a kind of ask me anything. You can ask me anything on anything related to interviews, related to anything. So that we'll discuss together. If you have any kind of doubts you want to ask, you can discuss with me. Okay. So this session will be divided into these three parts, right? So before going ahead, let's wait for 2 to 3 more minutes. I will start the session at 4, 6, and till that, let everyone join in who wants to join, so that everyone can take benefit. And then we'll start the session, okay? And जो भी लोग डाउट लिख रहे हैं क्लास में, एड्रेस एवरीवन, डोंट वरी, ओके? आई एड्रेस एवरीवन व्हाटएवर डाउट्स इट इज। सी प्लस प्लस और जावा, वांट व्हाट टू चूज फॉर कॉम्पिटिटिव प्रोग्रामिंग। संकेत संकेत, इट इज नॉट कि व्हाट टू चूज एक्चुअली, ठीक है? इट टोटली डिपेंड्स अपॉन यू। अगर देखो, अगर तुम्हें स्टार्ट करना है किसी प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज, अगर तुम्हें पहले से आइडिया नहीं है, देन आई विल सजेस्ट टू स्टार्ट विद सी प्लस प्लस, बिकॉज इट इज काइंड ऑफ इजी एज वेल। पाइथन इज ऑल्सो इजी, बट yes, C++ has a larger community size, right? So, जब तुम start करोगे, तो you will be like having a larger community. If you want some help, if you are stuck at some point, or if you are following any resource over Google or anything, then maximum resources are in C++ only, right? Maximum courses are you will find in C++. So that will help you a lot in your journey, right? But talking about other languages like Java and all, so you will not find so many resources. But as I don't have experience in Java, honestly. So, but one of my friend has started in Java. So later on, he switched to C++ just because no one is there in the college, in my college, who was good in Java. Right? So it will create a lot of problem later on. Okay? So that is the thing I'll tell you. No, Dhananjay. Nowadays my classes are not going on an academy. Okay? Nowadays it is on hold. Okay? We'll see from the next month. Okay? भैया, एस टी एल लाइब्रेरी यूज करके अगर सॉर्ट करें तो कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी ज्यादा होगी, और नॉर्मल फॉर लूप दो लगाए स्वैप करके सॉर्ट करें तो उसकी कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी ज्यादा। एस टी एल लाइब्रेरी की जो टाइम कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी होती है, ठीक है, वो एन लॉग एन होती है। वर्स्ट केस में कितनी होती है? एन लॉग एन, क्योंकि जो एस टी एल में जो सॉर्टिंग फंक्शन है, टाइम कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी उसकी एन लॉग एन क्यों होती है? क्योंकि वो इंट्रो सॉर्ट यूज करता है। इट यूजेस इंट्रो सॉर्ट एज इट सॉर्टिंग एल्गोरिथम। इंट्रो सॉर्ट इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ थ्री अदर सॉर्टिंग एल्गोरिथम्स, क्विक सॉर्ट, हीप सॉर्ट एंड इंसर्शन सॉर्ट। इट यूजेस दीज थ्री लाइक एल्गोरिथम्स टू डेवलप ए सिंपल एल्गोरिथम, राइट? दैट इज इंट्रो सॉर्ट, एंड द वर्स्ट केस कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी इज एन लॉग एन। बट इफ यू विल यूज सम अदर सॉर्टिंग एल्गोरिथम ऑफ एन स्क्वायर, ऑफ कोर्स दिस विल बी नॉट गुड देन दिस, राइट? सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द बेस्ट सॉर्टिंग एल्गोरिथम्स अवेलेबल टिल डेट। सो देर इज नो पॉइंट इन यूजिंग टू फॉर लूप्स, हूएवर हैज आस्क्ड। ओके ओके आशीष, आई विल ट्राई टू हेल्प यू आउट, डोंट वरी, आई विल ट्राई टू हेल्प यू आउट, आई विल ट्राई टू हेल्प एवरीवन इन द क्लास। सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग मच टाइम, लेट्स स्टार्ट एंड आई विल शेयर अ शॉर्ट जर्नी ऑफ व्हाट आई डिड एंड व्हाट रिसोर्सेज डिड आई फॉलो, एंड देन आई विल शेयर सम टिप्स दैट व्हाट शुड एक्चुअली वी डू, राइट? एंड द रियल ऑनेस्ट टॉक विल डू एंड ऑनेस्ट टॉक विल नॉट डू एनी की यार ये कुछ ऐसी बात है इम्प्रैक्टिकल सी, विल नॉट डू दोस काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स राइट. एकदम प्रैक्टिकल बात करेंगे ठीक है, ऑन ए ग्राउंड लेवल, ऑन ए ग्राउंड लेवल क्या कर सकते हैं हम अपने आप को इम्प्रूव करने के लिए, अपनी रेटिंग को इम्प्रूव करने के लिए. सो विल टॉक ऑन ए वेरी ग्राउंड लेवल, विल नॉट टॉक समथिंग हाइपोथेटिकल जो नहीं हो सकता राइट. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट थिंग विच आई वॉन्टेड टेल यू. सेकेंड थिंग इज आई स्टार्ट विथ माई जर्नी, शॉर्ट जर्नी, वेरी शॉर्ट जर्नी, इट विल नॉट बोर यू, आई आई बेट दैट तुम बोर नहीं हो गए इससे ठीक है. तो वेन आई वॉज इन माई फर्स्ट ईयर राइट, जब मैं फर्स्ट ईयर में आया था उस समय आई डिड आई डोंट हैड एनी क्लू ऑफ व्हाट कॉम्पिटेटिव प्रोग्रामिंग इज, व्हाट इज प्रोग्रामिंग एक्चुअली, एंड व्हाट आर द की स्किल्स दैट द इंटरव्यूअर और द रिक्रूटर विल लुक फॉर यू, लाइक द कंपनीज विल लुक फॉर इन यू राइट, टू व्हेन दे विल कम टू हायर यू राइट, व्हेन दे विल प्लेसमेंट सीजन एंड ऑल. बट व्हाट हैपेंड इज व्हेन आई मूव टू माय सेकंड ईयर राइट, इन माय फर्स्ट ईयर आई डिड नॉट डू कोडिंग, इन माय सेकंड ईयर व्हेन आई मूव टू माय थर्ड सेमेस्टर देन आई गॉट इन कॉन्टेक्ट विद द मेनी सीनियर्स राइट, मेनी सीनियर्स हु वेर इन फाइनल ईयर और हु वेर इन थर्ड ईयर राइट. तो दैट टाइम दे टोल्ड मी दैट देर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड एज कॉम्पिटेटिव प्रोग्रामिंग राइट, देर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड एज कोड शेफ, देर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड एज कोड फोर्सेस एंड देर आर मेनी अदर प्लेटफॉर्म्स अवेलेबल राइट. सो दे टोल्ड मी टू स्टार्ट विथ इट राइट, आई आस्क्ड व्हाई, व्हाई टू स्टार्ट विथ इट, देन तो दे टोल्ड दैट इट विल बूस्ट अप योर प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग स्किल्स, देन आई आस्क्ड व्हाई प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग स्किल्स वी नीड टू बूस्ट अप, देन ही टोल्ड दैट when you will sit for placements then in the interviews the interviewer will always ask you some coding questions right, coding question means questions based on data structures algorithms right, problem solving and all, so he will test your problem solving skills and competitive programming is one of the ways right, it is one of the ways to improve your problem solving skills right. So there was no factor of what ratings are, I don't have clue what of ratings are and all. I just started with CodeChef, right? I started with solving problems on CodeChef. I searched for various tutorials over YouTube that what are the different resources. I checked out different channels that to how to get started with it, how to solve your first problem and all. Then I started with CodeChef, right? And in the first long challenge, I still remember, I participated in the first long challenge. And in the first long challenge, trust me, I was able to solve only one problem. Long challenge was of 10 days, right? Long challenge takes place of 10 days. And in all the 10 days, I was only so able to solve one problem. And it is the time of, I think, June 2019, I think. June 2019, it is the time I'm talking about. June 2019 was my first long challenge, I remember, right? This is was my second year, when my second year was just about to start. Then I started with CodeChef. And in the first long challenge, I participated and I was able to solve only one problem. I didn't had clue of the second problem, that what the second problem wants me to ask, right? So that time it made me like there is a lot of things to know for now, right? It is not that you can directly go and practice and you can directly become a 5-star or a 4-star coder. It is not like that. You need to first understand some things, you need to first learn some things, and then only you will be able to perform in a contest. Then I asked my seniors, right? What are the things we should learn first, right? Because I'm not able to understand the second problem itself. In the first problem, still I was very I took a lot of time to understand what test cases are, what input and output means, right? How to solve a problem and everything, right? Okay, let's learn first STL, right? So STL proved to be one of the most powerful tools in my journey, right? So I started with C++. The first problem which I solved was in C programming, because that was part of my first semester and that I learned in my first semester. It's a little bit basic about C programming. I didn't had any programming experience from before. Then in my second year, someone told me that, hey, you cannot continue in C, right? You cannot solve harder problems in C because there are no inbuilt data structures or there are no inbuilt functions in C, right? There are no libraries in C. Then I started, okay, then I got to know that, okay, we need to learn a new language, that is C++, right? C++ was something that was just a upgrade of C, right? With a STL involved in it, right? Then STL, senior told me, right, that STL is one of the most powerful tools to start, right? Then I started with STL. I understood STL. And trust me, if you are doing in C++, then STL, every library, right, every data structure, every container, every iterator, every function should be well clear in your mind, right? Every thing should be remembered by you, that what is a map, what is an unordered map, what is a set, how to use it, right? How to use some containers inside another container, how to use vector of set, how to use set of vector. These kind of things should be able to be clearly visualized by you, right? So that is very, very important point. Then when I learned STL and then when I participated in the next contest, then I was able to solve three problems in the long challenge. I don't had any clue of short challenges. I just participated for long challenges for 8 to 9 months. I'm very honest. I've just participated in only long challenges for the starting of 8 to 9 months. I didn't had clue of what short challenges are. I just participated in CodeChef long challenges. Then I learned STL, right? Then STL is okay. STL helped me in solving 3 problems, right? But in the next contest, I was again able to solve only 3 problems, right? Then I come to know, right? Okay, now STL is done. Now I have the knowledge of language, right? How to write code, how to write basic code, which does not involve any higher level data structure, right? That I was able to solve. But now the fourth problem is some kind of algorithmic based, right? Algorithmic based means you need to learn some algorithms in order to solve those problems. Now I came to know, okay, what algorithm should I learn? I'll point out, I'll tell you the important topics, what I followed, what I learned, and what where from where I practiced on. Don't worry. But after this journey, I'll tell you, okay? Then I practice, okay? When you started coding sincerely, I started coding sincerely from the very start, okay, Purna. So it is not like, yeah, I did coding just for sake. When I started in my second year, so I'll tell you, okay, in my second year, that is my, in my third semester, I started coding, right? But in between, I left it for a while, right? When my semester exams came. But again, I started my fifth semester, right? So it is not like I did coding for sake. I did coding because I liked it, right? Then I learned a language. Then I got to know, okay, there are some algorithms to learn, right? There are some higher level things to learn. Then I learned about those things, right? What is a dynamic programming? What is binary search, right? How to solve binary search problems? What is a tree? What is a graph? What is dynamic programming again? What is a segment tree? What are the different topics, right? What is a stack? What is a queue? So these type of things came in my mind. Yes, okay, I need to learn these things first. Then only I will be able to solve fourth problem, right? So there is a particular roadmap. There is a particular thing, right? There is a particular step-by-step procedure to become good, anything, right? So it is not like you can directly solve a segment tree problem without learning recursion. So there is a series of topics which you need to learn in order to master those topics. I'll tell you what can be the right path. I'll tell you, don't worry. And what can be the right resource for that. Okay. I'll tell every resource which I mention here will be free of cost. Don't worry. Okay. So then I started to explore different platforms. I explored various platforms. Some of them are, I explored CSES problem set, right? And then I explored CodeChef, certification preparation program, and I explored SPOG. So these three platforms, I see, first tip which I will give you right now is, okay, don't pick up many platforms together, right? Always try to be stick at one or two platforms. That will always help you. If you will be stick to many platforms, then you will have a lot of confusion, right? In which platform you have to participate in a contest, in which platform you should practice and what to practice. So always try to like fix one or two platform for practicing and for giving the contest. You can give the contest on various platforms, but for practicing, just choose one or two platforms. That will always help you in your journey, right? That will make your task easier, as I will say, right? So I followed these one or two platforms concurrently, and I followed very sincerely this particular part, right? And trust me, when I became 3-star and sorry, when I became 4-star, I think, right? Till 4-star, I didn't thought ki, yeah, there is a lot of things to learn. But when after I became 4-star, I was just a constant for next 5 months. Next 4 to 5 months, I was not able to upgrade my rating. I was just sticked to 4-star, right? There was a point when I realized that there are a lot of things to learn. And then I came to explore this particular series, CodeChef Certification Preparation Program. What it is? इट इज की CodeChef एक अपना प्रोग्राम रखता है जो DSA सर्टिफाइड करता है लोगों को, ठीक है? अभी वो लॉकडाउन की वजह से बंद है, बट वो पहले होता था। तो उसके एक प्रिपरेशन की पूरी प्रोग्राम एक सीरीज बना रखी है CodeChef ने। तुम इनिशिएटिव्स में जाओगे, मैं दिखाऊंगा अभी खोलकर, वहां पर तुम खोल सकते हो। वहां पर पूरे टॉपिक वाइज ना क्वेश्चन है और टॉपिक वाइज रिसोर्सेस है, तो उनको तुम फॉलो कर सकते हो टू लर्न एडवांस डेटा स्ट्रक्चर्स, टू लर्न डेटा स्ट्रक्चर्स, हायर डेटा स्ट्रक्चर्स। ओके, तो मैंने ये फॉलो किया बहुत सिंसियरली 2-3 महीने तक, एंड मुझे एक ड्रास्टिक चेंज मिला। नेक्स्ट लॉन्ग चैलेंज में मुझे 5 या 6 प्रॉब्लम्स होने लगे फिर स्टार्टिंग में, ठीक है? और जुलाई वाज द लास्ट लॉन्ग चैलेंज विच आई पार्टिसिपेटेड एंड जिसमें मैं 5-स्टार हुआ था, राइट? तो जुलाई लॉन्ग चैलेंज ऑफ 2020, सो राइट, तो जून 2019 से मैंने स्टार्ट किया था। मैं सब रियलिस्टिक बात कर रहा हूँ, कोई भी ऐसी चीज नहीं जो हाइपोथेटिकल है। एंड मुझे फर्स्ट लॉन्ग चैलेंज में मैंने पार्टिसिपेट किया था जून 2019 में। जुलाई 2020 में मैं जाके 5-स्टार हुआ था, राइट? मैं एक प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व किया था मैंने इस कंटेस्ट में, इसके अंदर, ये डिवीजन 1 कहा जाता है, तो इसके अंदर मैंने 6 प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व किए थे, राइट? 6 या 5 किए थे, आई एम स्टिल नॉट रिमेंबर, राइट? सो दैट व्हाट आई वांट टू टेल यू कि बिफोर स्टार्टिंग अहेड राइट बिफोर थिंकिंग टू बिकम दीज काइंड ऑफ लेवल्स बस फर्स्ट ट्राई टू बी पेशेंट दैट विल ऑलवेज हेल्प यू. सो ट्राई टू थिंक ओके आई विल बी पेशेंट आई विल टेक टाइम राइट एवरी वन विल टेक टाइम टू बिकम दिस लेवल राइट. सो टेक टाइम इट इज अराउंड 1 ईयर यू कैन सी इट इज अराउंड 1 ईयर राइट. सो अराउंड 1 ईयर इट टुक मी टू बिकम 5 स्टार. सो इट इज नॉट लाइक यू कैन बिकम इन 3 to 4 months. इट इज ऑल रबिश हु सेज दैट यू कैन बिकम फॉलो दिस टू बिकम 5 स्टार इन 3 months फॉलो दिस टू बिकम 5 स्टार. इट टोटली डिपेंड्स अपॉन पर्सन टू पर्सन वॉट इज योर करेंट नॉलेज लेवल. डोंट कंपेयर योर सेल्फ विथ एनी वन राइट कि ही डिड इट इन 3 months सो आई माइट ऑल्सो डू इन 3 months. They, you two are both are different persons, right? What is his level? What is his level of mathematics? What is your level? So they are two totally different things, right? So, Saurav Kumar Priyadarshi, don't worry. I have seen your message and mail as well. I'll reply you by today, okay? Saurav Kumar Priyadarshi, I didn't got time to reply you. Sorry, bro. I'll reply you to by today itself. I am sure, okay? I promise you to reply by you today, okay? On the mail and on the LinkedIn, I saw your message. Don't worry. Okay. Now let's come back. So. This was the thing which I want to tell you. Keep like stick, be strict, right? So there is a particular series whenever you feel like whenever you feel that this is the threshold, right? Ki you cannot cross this threshold. Like this is the threshold, you cannot solve problems next to this level. You'll always you become constant at a particular time. Then that is the point where you need to start learning some things, right? Learning some things means learning some new data structures, learning some new concepts which you haven't have idea of. And then you can start again. So that is the thing which you should do whenever you feel that you are constant or you are stuck at a particular rating. That is the thing which you should realize, and that realization should be by yourself, right? So then I started like practicing a lot, and then I started that this was a short journey about myself. But when I became 5 star, right, I haven't, trust me, this is a clear honest thing, I haven't participated in any short contest in my lifetime. And that is one of the things which made me think here, like when the interview, like the when placements will come, we need to perform in the coding rounds in the short span of time in 2 or 3 hours, right? So that is the time when my senior suggested to start with the short challenges like lunchtime, cook off and those stuff. So then I started with those things, right? And after starting with those things, trust me, I was not able to perform well, because what matters is in the long challenge, there is a lot of time to practice. There is a lot of time to learn new things and then come and practice again. There is a lot of time to observe some things. But in the short challenges, problems are designed in such a way, right, that will require a lot of speed, right, accuracy, right? If you solve a problem and you submit it wrong, in the next time, it will take a lot of things, right? So that is something which you should practice. So short contest is a very, very important part of your journey. So then I started with short contest. I started with Code Forces. I started with Code Chef. I started with AdCoder. So 3 main things I did: Code Chef, Code Forces, and AdCoder. Right? I started giving all the short contests. Trust me, this was the most important and the most learning phase of my journey. That these three I started in after July 2020, and from July 2020 to January 2021. Right? For this year, I'm talking about. This phase was the most important. This was the lockdown phase as well, right? This was the most important and the most learnable, most productive journey part of my life, right? These kind of, I didn't have participated in any long challenge in these things. I only participated in short contests. Whether it can be on any platform, I just followed one. I'll just share one thing. You can go to clist.by. There is a website clist.by. You can see all the upcoming competitive programming contest over there, whether it can be on any platform. So I followed this particular website and I see, like, I kept track of what are the upcoming contests, like Google Kickstart, Google Code Jam, Hacker Cup, every like contest it will show a track of lead code inter questions, everything, right? So yes, Saurav, don't worry, okay? So these are the things which I followed, right? I gave every short contest on every contest, and trust me, this is one of the most important, and trust me, to increase your rating you need to give contest. So the most important thing is give as much contest as possible, right? After giving the contest, solve the problems you are not able to solve in the contest. That is upsolving part. I'll write the tips, don't worry about that, okay? So this part made me, like, when I started, then in December 2019, I remember that it took my 7 to 8 months to become expert at Code Forces. I become expert at Code Forces, right? I crossed 1600 rating at Code Forces, and a lot of new things I did, right? And at Coder, I participated, I improved, right? So this Code Forces, Code Chef, and at Coder helped me a lot in improving my short contest and in performing well in the short competitions, right? So this is the thing which I did. Next. Okay. what are the things which you should do, right? What are the things which you should do? So I'll answer every queries. Don't worry, after some time. Okay. So you can simply don't repeat your messages over the chat. I'll read every message which has come till now. And if you have something new to ask, you can drop in the chat box. I'll try to answer every doubt. Don't worry. Okay. So what are the things which you should follow, which you should follow? So I'm talking about, so if you are just starting, so you can go to and watch my previous session. I'll help you with that. So if you're just starting, okay, if you're just starting, you can go and watch my previous sessions. You can find in the video section. Just a minute. Okay. Yes, this one. How to scale up your star rating. So you can, this was happened in the last one part, right? So you can watch this session, right? I'll share the link. Because if you are just starting, then that is the best thing which you can follow. Sorry. Okay. So I'll just share the link. I think you might have got it. So this is the thing you can do. Right. You can, I think this message will not be delivered. You can simply go to the CodeChef video section, and inside this video section, you can find the link. Where it is. Yes. How to scale up your star rating on CodeChef. So this is for them who are just starting with like competitive programming, right? And there are a lot of playlists in the CodeChef YouTube channel. You can follow this. Anybody can code 2.0 if you're just starting with competitive programming. There I have just started from the very basics. What is programming? What is competitive programming, right? How to start with C++, how to start with STL and everything. And I just solved some contest problems over there. So that you can follow. That is a 5-day series that took place in the past. And what else I want to share with you all, I'll share with that, right? So this session is for them who are at somewhere around 3-star and 4-star, let's say, right? And who want to like cross this boundary, who want to become 5-star or 6-star, let's say. So this is for them, right? This is not for them who were just starting, because they will not be they want to start, right? So starting is something which is the most difficult part, trust me. And the next difficult part is to be an exceptional programmer, right? Because 3-star and 4-star is the range in which the maximum people around you are already there. So but you will not find a lot of people in 5-, 4-, 6-star ratings, right? So this is the most important part. This is the most important transition which you will make, which will make you an exceptional coder. No, Akhil, you cannot you can be with me. I'll suggest everything for you as well, okay? Don't worry. Thank you, Kaushik. Thank you so much for the compliment. Right now, let's move forward. So, what I'm trying to tell you is, okay. So now, let's start without wasting much time. Okay, I'll tell you, Dhananjay. Don't worry. Okay. So, what are the topics which you should learn before doing these things? I'll write those topics first of all, because that is the one of the most important part. Because as you will proceed forward, the most important part is what topics should we actually learn, right? So that I will tell you. So I will write the topics that you should learn, right? So talking about in general, if I talk about then any normal you should learn any programming language, as I already told you. And after learning any programming language, solve some basic problems over HackerRank, CodeChef and every platform. Solve some basic problems, very basic problems. It should not be very hard. And after solving some basic problems, you can start participating in contests. After you solve 100 to 200 problems on different platforms, you can start participating in contests. You can start participating in long challenges, cook-off, lunchtime and all. Then you will ultimately become good with time, right? But there are some topics which you should focus on, right? So what are the topics? Topics are, see, for those who are at 3-star and 4-star, right? And who wants to transition their rating to 5-star or 6-star, let's say, right? For them, what are the topics? What are the most important topics which I felt when I was at 4-star, I felt that these topics are not very strong in me. And these topics, problems come in the long challenges based on these topics, on the short challenges based on these topics. So these topics should be very well framed in my mind. So what topics are they? First one is recursion. So you should master recursion first, right? Because recursion is one of the topics which will come in every, when you will go forward, when you learn graphs, right? When you will learn dynamic programming, when you will learn divide and conquer, right? When you will learn segment trees, right? When you learn tree, everywhere recursion will come. When you learn backtracking, right? The list is endless, trust me. So recursion is some kind of another part of programming, right? So this is not something which is a part of programming, I'll say. This is another programming, I'll say. So recursion is something which is mind-blowing, Trust me. So first thing which you should start practicing is recursion. Just learn the basic of recursion, and all these topics which I write here, solve 20 to 25, not 20 to 25, it will be much. I'll say 10 to 20 problems, 10 to 20 quality problems, I'll say. Just solving problems is not enough. If you are able to solve a current level problem, so you should not always solve that level, right? You should always try to upgrade yourself. So this is not ki tumhe usi level ke problems ko solve karna hai. Try to solve some harder levels which you cannot solve directly, right? Which should take time, right? So that is the most important thing, ki solve problems comparatively harder than your current level. That will only improve you. That will only help you in performing well in the upcoming competitions. So recursion is the first thing which I'll suggest. And actually, you should master STL as well, right? In STL, what are the things, right? Vectors, stacks. This should be well mastered by you. Queues. Solve problems on these topics. Solve a problem on these topics as much as possible. Set and map. And trust me, this is very, very, very important. Very, very, very important data structure. That is a map. Right, so you should solve problems on these topics, right? What are the other topics? I'll say, what are the other topics? The other topics are, let's say, heaps. You should practice heaps as well, right? Hashing, I'll say, hashing is a very important concept, right? Where you can find problems based on these topics, those quality problems, that I will tell you. Don't worry, okay? That problems I will tell you where to solve. This is just the I'll say the task which you need to perform. In the next slide, I'll tell you the resources where you can find these problems. So just write it anywhere. What else? Greedy algorithms or greedy techniques. I will say greedy techniques, right? Apart from this, what can be the other things? The most important part is dynamic programming. Right. And then what else can be there? What else can be there? Graphs, trees, right? And one more thing I missed, that is number theory. Number theory is also a very important part. Number theory. In number theory, like what is a GCD, what is a LCM and everything. These things that should be well clear to you. And one more thing I missed it. That is a binary search, I'll say. Binary search. This is, don't leave it as. Binary search is not just finding an element in a sorted array. It is a lot more than that. To solve 10 to 15 problems, quality problems, right? You can find those quality problems from LeetCode or SPOJ or from CodeChef. You can apply tax filter to apply problems based on topics. So you can follow these topics, solve some quality problems on these topics before you go ahead. So you just stop here. Just give yourself a break, right? Just give yourself a break of 10 to 15 days or a month, let's say, and try to practice as much as possible, right? You can follow different platforms, right, to practice. You can choose 2 to 3 platforms and you can stick to those platforms and practice problems, right? So these are the topics, some of the topics which I remember that are important for you to go ahead from this to this transition, right? So solve some quality problems, right? What are the other things, right? What are the other things? Other topics which you will go to advanced is number theory. I already told you number theory, right? What else you can do is you can learn segment trees, right? Segment trees is very, this is also a very important in competitive programming, very important in competitive programming, right? In long challenges, the problems comes based on segment trees, right? And what else, let's say, in DP, there is a concept SOS DP, you call it as a bit mask as well, bit mask DP. So these topics are also very, very important as you go forward. Then square root decomposition. Right. These are the some advanced topics which will come after these things. Then matrix exponentiation. Right. And a lot more things are there, like Fenwick trees, like binary index trees, right? Fenwick trees, right? And there are many other things like heavier light decomposition, Fourier transform. So these are some advanced topics which you should learn about, at least advanced topics which you should learn. You should have at least knowledge of these things. What are they? Right. So these are some things. These topics are some things. These are some like a particular concept, right? Particular concept, or I'll say particular data structure which you should master. So how can you master? Solve some quality problems based on these topics. 10 to 20 problems for each topic. So it will, a total of 200 problems you should be able to solve in, let's say, 2 to 3 months to do that transition, right? To do that transition. Along with it, give contest, give contest, and absolve problems after the contest. That you should do along with it. That is not ki tum usse chhod rahe ho, right? And apart from this, what are the algorithms which you should learn? What are the algorithms which you should learn? I'll tell you that as well. Okay? So I'll answer queries. Don't worry. I'll answer queries in the next time. After the next 5 minutes. So these are the topics which you should follow. Now, from where to practice these problems? From where? So from where there is a lot of answers for that. So the first thing can be CodeChef. You can go to CodeChef. Preparation C's, I'll show that instead of writing here. You can just go to CodeChef. That's what I'm telling Singham. So you can just go to CodeChef. And the best thing which I feel is you can go to our initiatives, and under our initiatives you can go to CodeChef certification. Okay, inside this CodeChef certification, there is a option of prepare, right? There is an option of prepare. So you can click on prepare. After you click on prepare, there are two levels, foundation and advanced. So it totally depends upon you. If you are at 3-star, I'll suggest to see what topics are weak in you, right? These are the topics which are very important. These are something which I already discussed about. And in number theory, the most important part is prime numbers. Master prime numbers, right? Learn about sieves of Iranto, whatever it is, right? And primarily testing, right? Prime testing and everything. Like you should be able to master you should be able to find the prime factors and everything. These things are comes up in the contest many times. So these everything will be covered from this syllabus, right? So this is a kind of syllabus which is prepared for CodeChef certification exam, but you can follow this for learning data structures as well, right? So this is the foundation level where you can follow these 11. So you can see by yourself, it totally depends upon you ki what topics are weak, right? So you can see basic recursion, greedy algorithms, basic DP, string matching, right, sorting and binary searching. So these topics you can follow from here. You can see that for each topic, you can see the list of problems, practice problems. In each topic, there is a resource section and there is a practice problem section. So you can solve that problems, right? And you can refer these resources if you want. That totally depends upon you. After you now imagine that, okay, I know all these topics very well, right? So if you perform well in these problems, if you're able to solve problems, so don't try to solve all the problems because it will take a lot of time and you will be not able to solve as well. So what you can do is solve two problems from starting, solve 2-3 problems in the middle, and solve some problems from the last part, right? So choose 4 regions inside this and solve problems, right? Not you can skip some problems, but try to cover all the range, like, because these problems are arranged in difficulty level wise, right? So these problems are easy. Now try to increase some level, right? Try to increase some more level and try to increase some more level. So these can be the right way to approach these problems. If you'll go and try to solve every problem, it will take a lot of time. Now you can give this mock test to see what whether you are able to perform well or not, right? Because this mock test is completely based on these topics. And after this, there is an advanced level, right? In the advanced level, you can see the topics are quite hard, right? Which I mentioned there, like heaps, disjoint set unions. This is a topic in trees, segment trees, right? Frenwick trees, right? Tree traversals and tree DP, right? And a different least common ancestor is a different paradigm inside, right? This is a very important topic as well. Now, grid graph algorithms, right? How to find minimal spanning tree. Prim's algorithm, Kruskal. These are some important algorithms which you should learn about. Prim's, Kruskal's, Dijkstra's, Bellman, Ford, Floyd, Warshall, right? Topological sorting and all, right? After this, you can see mortised, amortised analysis, divide and conquer, advanced DP problems, CBOF. This is what I was talking about. So you can start practicing problems from here, right? So you can, similarly, you can follow this part. Like, for example, if you can see segment trees part, this is very long. This is very long, right? This is very long, right? In segment trees, you can see there are 34 problems. So you cannot solve 34 problems based on one topic. What you can do, you can choose 4-5 problems from beginning, then from the middle and from the end, right? So you can do this, right? Follow this and imagine that, okay, I have learned, right? I'm solving this, but I'm not able to solve the problems, right? I'm having difficulty in solving the problems. So what to do, right? What to do? I'm not able to solve the problems. If you miss the step, Williams, what you can do is you can just go back 10 minutes and you can watch the session again, okay? I'll tell you what to do for everything. Now imagine that, okay, I'm solving the problems, but I'm not able to solve these problems. For example, you are able to solve first 2 problems of heaps and then you are having difficulty in solving the next problems. It means, okay, there is a particular topic in heaps, right, that is not known to you, So what you can do is you can simply go to Google. You can simply go to Google. For example, I want to learn about heaps. So you can load heaps tutorial. Heaps tutorial. After writing heaps tutorial, what will come? What will come? Heaps tutorial. Okay. Heaps tutorial. So what will come? There will be a lot of tutorials will come up, and I will suggest to go with HackerEarth, right? I'll suggest you to go to HackerEarth. And HackerEarth, there are many good tutorials of different topics, right? For example, I want to learn segment trees. So I'll write segment tree, HackerEarth. That's it. You will find the segment tree tutorials. So these are very good tutorials. I'll suggest a very clear, right? A different from the very basics. It explained everything, right? With code and everything. So here you can learn those concepts. Right? For example, this is heap. So you can follow these different resources to learn about different things. And HackerEarth provides a very good tutorials in this case. Apart from this, right, so you can follow CP algorithms for learning something, cplgorithms.com. So there is a top CP algorithms, right? In CP algorithms, you can see this is cplgorithms.com, simple. So you can see different topics, and there is a very like beautifully written different like if you want to learn, let's say, string hashing, right? So you can click on string hashing and you can learn about this. So there you will find a pseudo code in C++. So this will also help you a lot in like learning new things. So you can follow this as well. If you like reading, you can follow these things, right? So if you like videos, then you can follow different YouTube channels who teach, right? But apart from this, if you like reading, you can follow these tutorials of CP algorithms, HackerEarth. Apart from this, if you want to learn, if you want to have a book or based on competitive programming, you can follow this CP handbook. You can just simply write CP handbook over Google. You will find it. Competitive Programmer's Handbook. You can click it and the book will open up, right? And you can download it. You can download it. This book is very, very good. This book is very, very good. It will help you to start with very basics, right? And it every topic is covered from very basic to advanced, from with clear intuition and all, right? So this is what you can do after this, right? So there are many things which I told. So the first thing was to like you can select, you can follow this particular certification program to practice problems. Yes, yes, Vector. Yes, Vector. That's what I said, na? Ki don't be Swiss to many languages. What I told is, practice problems from here. Simple, in simple words, what I'll say is, practice problems from this list based on different topics, right? Whenever you feel difficulty in a particular topic, let's say, you are not able to solve the problem, you can just go to Google, right? Forget about these two things. This is for someone who wants more resources. Just forget about these two. You can simply go, want to learn about segment trees. You can write segment trees HackerEarth. You will find the tutorial. You can read it from here, right? So this is a tutorial which you can follow. Apart from this, what you can do, you can go to YouTube, right? You can go to the CodeChef YouTube channel. CodeChef YouTube channel. Inside this CodeChef YouTube channel also, you will find a lot of resources here in the video, in the playlist section also. And if you're liking the content, please, please, please consider liking the video as well. Please like the video, okay? In the playlist section, you will find a lot of resources. Right, lot of resources. For example, for any contest like lunchtime, starters, cook off, long challenge, whenever the long challenge will end, over, immediately the solutions will get uploaded here. Right, so this is also very good point. Interview preparation, and then beginners, for beginners, there is a lot of playlist here. And like if you want to learn by topics, you can learn from here. Right, then I will suggest to follow this playlist. That is okay, yeah, this one. So that this is a Snackdown 2021 preparation series. You can follow this to learn any topic. For example, you want to learn segment trees. So you can find the basics of segment trees problem. It is taken by me only. Okay. It was taken by me only. Basics of segment trees and range queries. So you can follow these resources like to learn if you want to learn from videos. So this is called CodeChef YouTube channel. So that is all you can do, right? That is all you can do to become good. And what else is your doubts? You can ask now. So I'll just write it on some points. I'll write it in some points. Okay. So the first thing is solve problems topic wise. Have patience. That's it. Have patience, right? Whenever you feel like difficult, a topic is difficult, learn that topic. Whenever something new comes up, what I mean by having difficulty is whenever something new comes up, for example, you have learned recursion, but whenever a DFS problem is coming for the first time, you are not able to solve it. That means you need to learn DFS then, right? So you need to first learn DFS, then you need to solve some problems based on DFS, then only you will learn DFS, right? So learn that topic, learn that concept, And for learning that concept, there are many ways, right? First way can be tutorials, right? Tutorials, you can find it over Google on HackerEarth, on CP algorithms and everything. And videos can be on the CodeChef YouTube channel. That is the best resource I'll recommend for that. okay, because that is taken by the best educators available to them, right? Learn that concept, come back and solve that problem, right? After learning that concept, what you can do is you can solve some basic problems on that. For the first time, you can solve some basic problems on that, and then you can come back to this where you felt like difficult, right? And you can again start with solving problems, right? If you feel again, you feel that this is difficult, then you can search for the video solution for that problem, right? You will find it over YouTube, uploaded by anyone, right? You can start again. This is the process which you need to perform. And if someone is asking what is the time will take, this will take, this totally depends upon you. What is your time commitment daily? How much time you are giving to this? What is your current level, right? And how much sincere and how much motivated are you to do this? That is totally depends upon you, whether you are able to do it in 1 month or 2 month or 3 month or even 1 year, right? That totally depends upon you. That totally depends upon your grasping power and your mind, right? That anyone cannot tell you. So that is hypothetical point at how much time it will take, right? But on a rough figure, I'll say that if you follow this for 3 months, I'll say ki 1 week, like you can follow one topic 3 to 4 days. So in 1 month, let's say you can, for example, if you follow 4 days, if you stick to one topic, right? So in 1 week, there are, in 1 month, there are 30 days. So how many topics you can cover 30 by 4? That is 7 topics. So in 3 months, you can cover 7 into 3 are 21 topics, right? They are the 21 most important topics are 21 only. There are topics more than that, but still, like 21 topics are good to start, right? So these you can follow the on a rough figure, 3 months will take to become a good programmer. And by this way, you can learn a lot, right? This learning part will be very, very great if you follow this part. Right, so this is not any hypothetical something, right, which you cannot do. This is not something, this is not a video on how to become 5-star in 3 months. This is a video on how to actually improve yourself, and automatically the rating will improve, right? That's all, guys. So now I'll write some points that tips, I'll say that I'll call it as tips that you can really follow for learning, right? The first thing is, what are the benefits of becoming a 5-star coder, right? First of all, what are the benefit of becoming a 5-star coder? Why to become a 5-star coder? There are many benefits, right? Trust me. You will be able to get a referrals from, like for example, if you message anyone over LinkedIn that I want a referral at Amazon or I want a referral at Google. So how the employee will look like, what the employee will look in you, right? He will look your coding profiles on different platforms. But if you did it by cheating, right? Because someone has a problem, like if someone did it by cheating, then he might get a referral. No, he might not get, right? Because nowadays the persons who refer, right, are a little more smart, right? They will observe your profile, right? Whether this is being attained by cheating or not. Because a person who cheats, the graph will look like this, right? But a person who don't cheat, he will come back, he will go forward, he'll come back, he'll go forward, like this, the rating will come, right? Or this is not key, it is true for everyone, it is true for everyone, but yes, for example, in the short contest, we can simply judge if the person is already always increasing, that means something is wrong, right? Because in short contest, it might be possible that the ratings will go down up, like this will happen, right? For example, I'll show you my CodeForces profile. I'll show my CodeForces profile. For example, this is my CodeForces profile. Okay, so you can see I started with this is a default rating which CodeForces provided me in the starting. So I started with this. Then I came down, and you can see I came down, and then here I came to know, yes, okay, I need to learn something. Then I started again. I again come down. See, you can see my rating, right? After around 100 contests, I will say not 100. I'll say after 50 to 60 contests, I become a specialist, right? And after more than 100 contests, I become expert, right? And after expert, again, I became a specialist, and again, I became expert very hard, right? So that is something, and nowadays I'm not giving contests due to my internships and everything, but yes, I'll be. So I have given 102 contests. So every time your ratings will be minus, plus, minus, plus. So if I will share this profile with anyone, then he will be able to see my struggle, right? He will see my efforts, right? That how much he given time into this CodeForces, in building this CodeForces profile. So that will make an impact. Okay, this person can be referred. So this is the one of the important reasons. But if I'll show you my CodeShip profile, so I already participated in long challenges. So inside this, you will only find long challenges here, right? So July long challenge, then May long challenge, right? April, right? March, February, January. So I was very regular in giving long challenges, right? And then you can see October and September. So I was very regular in giving long challenges, right? So here you cannot see the fall because I was only participating in long challenge. I kept on improving myself. And when I became, okay, I was in good in long challenge. I take time and I'm able to solve. Then I started with code forces and everything, right? So this is the thing which I want to tell you. So cheating will not make you happy. I'm into placements. I'm sitting in many placements, right? So interviewer don't care, right, what is your rating on different platforms. He only cares whether you're able to solve that problem which is asked in the interview or not. So trust me, cheating will not help you at any point of time. Later on, you will get its punishment. Trust me, let's get its punishment, okay? So there is no ways, like we cannot, like we at CodeChef are trying hard to avoid plagiarism, but that is not 100% attainable, right? That is an hypothetical thing. We cannot stop you from cheating, right? But yes, it will make you bekar, like, trust me. Kuch nahi hone wala usse. Trust me, I am into placement in the final year mein, wo bahut sari companies mein baitha hai. Kuch aisa nahi hota ki wo tumhara jo rating hai usse kuch zyada farak nahi padta, right? One of my friends who didn't have done competitive programming, right, who didn't had so much ratings on different platforms, right, she is still able to get a 19 lakh package, right, because the interviewer is still not care, like, what pack, what interview, like, what ratings do you have. He or she will only care, like, what problem solving skills do you have, and that will be yours, right? So what happens is, for example, if you are a 5-star rated coder, right, I'll tell you what is the scenario. For example, if you are a 5-star rated coder at CodeChef, let's say, so when you are in an interview and you will tell the interviewer that I am a 5-star rated at CodeChef, so the interviewer will keep in mind that you are rated 5 stars. So he will assume, right, ki you might have very great problem solving skills, you might have very great DSA knowledge. So the interviewer will ask problems on that level only. And if you are not able to, if that rating is not yours, you will not be able to answer those problems in the interviews, right? So that is the case you should always remember of. Like, you might teach an interview, but the interviewer will ask problems based on your resume, na? Right? On your resume. If you are from ECE background, he will or she will not ask you much on computer fundamentals. It totally depends upon those things, right? So if that rating is yours, then only you will be able to answer those questions. Trust me. So that does not make any sense. So the first, I'll write some steps. The first thing which I'll suggest is brutal practice. Brutal practice. Brutal practice means practice as much as problems as possible, right? Study topics, right? And practice questions, right? And trust me, the only common thing which you can see in very great competitive programmers who are red or who are 6-star or 5-star, the only common thing is they have solved a lot and lot of problems in their lifetime, right? There is a lot of problems they have solved in their lifetime. They have solved 1,000, 2,000 problems in their lifetime. That is the only thing which will make you better. So this is the first step, which is the most important one that you have to solve very, right? And the second one is give as many contests as possible. Give as many contests as possible. Right? The third point is upsolve. Upsolve means whether you are, for example, you are able to solve 3 problems in the contest, solve the next problems after the contest by seeing anything, right? And the fourth point, but not the last, it is the most important point, is surround yourself with good friends, good coders, I will say, right? And discuss with them. Because as we already know, right, ki tumhare aaspaas jaise log uthte baithte hai tumhare saath, tumhari 80% happiness usi pe depend karti hai, right? So always surround yourself with good people who are into coding, who have a similar kind of aim as you have. So that will help you to discuss with them, to build a competitive nature, healthy competition among yourself, right? That will help you a lot in practice. And this is the most important point, and this helped me a lot, right? I have a group of 5 to 6 friends who are always discussing everything together, like whenever, and we always share opportunities with ourselves, right? Whenever there is an upcoming opportunity, right? We participate in the contest. After the contest, we discuss, right, what is the approach which you followed. We conduct a meeting also. Like, we did it in the past. After each Code Forces contest, we did a Google Meet and we discussed, like, what problems you solved. If you have solved third problem, can you please explain to others? That is the best thing which you can do. And you can, form a gym kind of thing. You can give virtual contest with your friends. That is the best thing which you can improve. Right? This is the four important points from my side and summing up the session, right? So, Now I will just answer some queries of you in the next 10 minutes, and then we'll end the session. Okay, fine. if I become 5-star, I'll automatically become good in DSA without lead code. Hey Vector, yes, this is the point. Yes, this is the point. Hey Vector, because if you have become 5-star, that means that you have learned a lot of DSA, right? You have very lot of DSA knowledge. So you, what happens is, if you have become a 5-star coder at CodeChef, then when you will solve lead code problems, then you will be able to solve it directly, right? It is not, देखो, कुछ problems ऐसे हैं, कुछ problems ऐसे हैं, some problems are there who which needs to be addressed separately, like linked list problems and everything. So those concepts should be learned specific for the interviews, for the specific for the interviews. Okay, so that is a different thing. But yes, if you became 5-star or if you became expert, then lead code, some the most of the lead code problems, easy and medium, that will seem like a piece of cake for you, because you have been into competitive programming for a long time, right? That will help you a lot in solving lead code or in performing well in interviews. That will help you a lot. Okay, and that is the important thing, right? So, but yes, when the interviews will come, still you have to do some lead code. You still have to like search for problems of that particular, like for example, Amazon's interviews coming, search for problems like in Amazon, which usually asks. So you have to solve that problems, practice problems before the interviews. That is the important thing. Whenever you are in a final year, or whenever you reach your sixth semester, I will recommend a starting lead code and interview bit for your placements. Okay. Yes, exactly. Hey Vector, no, for solving B and C of contest, I don't think you should go for segment trees, DP and graph, because in Code Forces contest, till A, B and C, there is no data structure like graph or DP. Okay, basic DP can come up, but not segment trees will not come up for sure. So you should not go for learning these topics. Instead, what you can do is, you can pick up some contest, past contest, and you can solve practice problems B of level B and C, right? And if you are not able to solve, see editorial, right? Try to think and solve again. Try to solve 100 to 200 problems, because A, B, C don't involves any higher level topics that involves in D and E and F level, right? So I don't think like I have I am able to today. I am always able to solve 3 problems of Code Forces contest division 2. So like I don't feel that segment trees is important for third problem, till third problem, right? It can come from fourth. Okay, so I'll suggest you to practice problems related to B and C level, that rating problem. Okay. Does the rating helps in cracking placements? I already told you, Ashutosh, I already answered that question. No, it does not help, sir. Ratings helps you in like building a brand, I will say, or like if you want a referral, that might help you, but that rating should be yours, right? If the rating is attained by really you, that will help you a lot in the placements, because you are able to tell the interviewer that I am into coding competitions, I have performed this much, I have my best rank is this and this. So the interviewer will have a look, yes, he has been into coding for his 4 years of life. So he will have that in mind, and then he will ask those problems, that problems. And if you are able to tell those problems, then that is a very good edge which you will be with you over the other candidates, right? And it also helps in some kind of shortlisting process, that some companies shortlist based on ratings. That will also help you in that point, okay? Yes, William, it is not advisable, I will say, but yes, it may help you as well. For example, when I learned DSU, right, when I learned DSU, then that is something for the first time which I learned when. So I didn't had any idea, right, ki kya kar rahe hai, why to do, right. So I memorized some functions like find and merge function. But later on, what it will happen is, when you will like use that particular memorized thing for a longer time of, for let's say 10 times, 15 times, then it will be automatically remembered by you, right? Then you are not required to memorize it explicitly. That will come in your mind default, right? So now I am not able, like I now that DSU code is now clear in my mind what actually I am doing. So it in the beginning, if you are memorizing something, it is fine. I don't think it is something which you should not do. Later on, with practice, you will be able to learn that as well. Okay. How to become constant in rating? Dhananjay, constant in rating means, see, you have to be consistent. Constant rating means you have to be consistent. Consistent means keep solving problems daily, right? Don't leave the problem. See, keep solving problems daily. Practice problems daily, right? Don't see ki you don't have to practice. Be regular in solving problems. Don't keep a long gap, right? Don't keep a long gap of more than 3 to 4 days. Right, keep solving 1 to 2 problems, and that problems should be of quality level. That problem should be higher level as that level of the problem should be higher as compared to your level, right? For example, if you're solving up to C level, then you should be like you should be practicing problems of D level in the practice part. You should not be practicing A, B, C. You should be practicing D. So that is the thing which I should well recommend. Keep participate in contest. Don't leave contest, right, in fear of losing the rating. Participate in contest. Don't worry about that. And after the contest, absolve the problems you are not able to solve in the contest. I think this is the best way to be consistent, right, and constant in rating. And one more thing, no one is absolute constant in the ratings, or everyone will fall again, rise again, fall. So contest to contest may depend karta hai what actually is your performance. Okay, exactly. Hey Vector, yes, exactly. That's what I'm telling. Keep focused on one platform. That is a very good thing, right? You can use other platforms as well along with it, right? It is not something which you should not do. But yes, if it disturbs you, if it confuses you that what to do and from where to practice, then I'll recommend to choose only one or two platform. Your confusion should be minimum, na? Right? That is what I am telling you. How to practice graph problems? Graph problems, what I will recommend is chessboard type problems. Then I'll recommend first to learn graphs, right? Learn graphs. There are many resources. You can search over YouTube. There are many YouTube channels which teaches graphs. After learning graphs, you can search some standard problems, right? Always try to get quality problems, means some standard problems. There are some standard problems on every data structure, right? So solve those standard problems when you learn that data structure. So those standard, for example, if you learn a graph, then learn about connected components, learn about DFS, BFS, right? Learn about finding cycles in a graph, right? Learn about there is a problem, count number of islands in a graph. That problems you should be able to solve, right? Sai Reddy saying using STL. I think you don't have what idea of what STL is. That is not we will discuss today. Okay, STL is simply a library which will allow us to use different data structures, right? That will help us to reduce the lines of code. That's it. Okay. Right. For example, if you want to use a stack, there is an inbuilt stack in STL that you can use it. You want to use a queue, you can use an inbuilt queue. You want to use a heap, you can use an inbuilt heap inside STL, right? That is what STL is. Saurav Kumar Priyadarshi, I'll reply by today. Trust me, I'll reply by today. Okay? Saurav Kumar Priyadarshi, I'll reply you by today, end of day. Don't worry. Aditya Pratap Singh is saying, I'm from electrical. Okay? Aditya, don't think ki you are from electrical branch. Forget about you are being. See, anyone is from CS branch. Trust me, in college, it is not ki college mein bahut acha aisa kuch khas padhate nahi hai. Theek hai? Toh koi bhi hai na, koi bhi branch ka ho, bhale CS ka hi ho, usko coding to khud se hi time nikal ke karni padegi. Theek hai? Toh ye bol jao ki tum electrical mein ho. Kyunki it does not make any difference whether you are from electrical branch or whether you are from CS branch. It does make difference to some extent ki jab maan lo तुम्हारे सीएस के सब्जेक्ट्स होते हैं, कंप्यूटर डेटा स्ट्रक्चर एंड ऑल, वहां पे तुम्हें सीएस वालों को थोड़ा ज्यादा फायदा होगा कि उन लोगों को पढ़ाया जा रहा है क्लास में. बट ट्रस्ट मी, कॉम्पिटेटिव प्रोग्रामिंग में जब जाओगे तो सब कुछ तुम्हें खुद से करना है, राइट? तुम्हारी प्रैक्टिस खुद से करनी है, तो भूल जाओ कि तुम इलेक्ट्रिकल के हो. ठीक है? अपने जो सेमेस्टर के सब्जेक्ट्स है उनको एक पर्टिकुलर टाइम दो, जो जितना रिक्वायर्ड है उतना दो. ठीक है? प्रायोरिटी ज्यादा रखो अपनी कोडिंग पर, कोडिंग को ज्यादा प्रायोरिटी रखो. तो प्रायोरिटी जब कर दोगे ना, तो दैट विल बी ए गुड थिंग, राइट? Yes, city of that. Yes, CodeChef really pays money price, man. Why he will not pay? Okay. Yes, actually, yes, hey Victor. You first improving, you should. The best thing is to solve problems from past contests. That is the best thing you can do. Okay. Dhananjay is asking, are you planning to? I am not sure, Dhananjay, because currently my internships are started and I am already placed at good companies. So I'm trying for good company. So I don't think I have much time to again go into CP. But yes, once I like start my full-time job, I'll again start CP because that's what I want to do. Okay? So I will again start the CP and then we'll see what to do forward. Okay. So thank you so much for being with me, guys. And that's all for today's session. Hey Vector, I already told you, na, try to solve C level problems in the practice section. Then only after solving like 15 to 20 problems, let's say, or 50 problems, let's say, in the next contest, it might be possible that you are able to solve the third problem also. And I will always recommend ki, for example, agar tumse do problem ho gaya hai contest mein, to always try to solve the third problem as well, right? always try to solve third problem as well. Okay, OP, आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू कि जो मैंने टॉपिक्स बताए हैं उन टॉपिक्स पे जरूर फोकस करो. उन टॉपिक्स में वीक हो गए, उन टॉपिक्स पे उतनी तुम्हारी प्रैक्टिस नहीं है, सिर्फ इसके लिए तुम्हें 3 स्टार पर तुम्हारी अटकी हुई है. ठीक है, 3 स्टार पर अटकने का सिर्फ ये मतलब है कि तुम्हारे टॉपिक्स थोड़े हैं ना वो स्ट्रांग नहीं है और तुमने प्रैक्टिस उतनी नहीं करी है. तो वो टॉपिक्स पढ़ो और उस पर प्रैक्टिस करो प्रॉब्लम्स को. दैट इज द ओनली वे विच यू कैन डू. एंड समराइजिंग द होल सेशन इन वन पॉइंट, यू नीड टू प्रैक्टिस एज मच एज पॉसिबल. देर इज नो शॉर्टकट टू बिकम 5 स्टार और देर इज नो शॉर्टकट टू बिकम एनी attain any rating. Only the shortcut is to practice, right? That's all guys for having me, and we'll see you all in the next session. Thank you so much and wish you all the best. Okay. स्मिति राज, यू कैन फॉलो बोथ ऑफ देम, राइट? इट टोटली डिपेंड्स अपॉन क्या तुम्हारे लिए वर्क कर रहा है. अगर तुम्हें लगता है कि यार तुम्हें डिफिकल्टी लेवल से टैग लगा के प्रॉब्लम सही से हो रहे तो उस तरीके से करो, नहीं तो यू कैन फॉलो टॉपिक वाइज एज वेल. बट टॉपिक वाइज ज्यादा रिकमेंडेड है क्योंकि एक टॉपिक को तुम एक समय पे अच्छे से कर रहे हो. ठीक है, दूसरा वे भी कर सकते हो, तो ऐसा कर सकते हो, कभी टॉपिक वाइज कर लो, कभी डिफिकल्टी वाइज कर लो.